Hello everyone, and welcome to another episode of All About DMSO. Now in this video, I thought we could try and answer some more frequently asked questions regarding DMSO to maybe give some helpful guidance to people who are unfamiliar with it or indeed new to using it. I think it might also be a good idea to recommend a few of the books that I often refer to when I'm looking for a DMSO related query as well. So this is the first book, and it's entitled Everything You Need to Know About DMSO. Now this is a good all-round beginner's guide, and it gives us in brief detail most do's and don'ts and answers a wide range of questions. The other two books, this one is The DMSO Handbook for Doctors by Archie H. Scott, and DMSO Nature's Healer by Dr. Morton Walker. Now these two books are a more in-depth understanding of DMSO, with many first-hand accounts of people using it, as well as case studies of DMSO being prescribed to patients and showing the documented results of scientific studies and its use. Now, I personally recommend reading any of these books, all of which can be purchased online, with several other books concerning the subject of DMSO. Okay, let's get back to frequently asked questions. Now we had some brilliant feedback on one of our previous videos, and we were asked a number of questions concerning dilution, which we answered, but I thought I'd cover some of those questions here as well. So the first question asked was, how could I make a smaller amount of DMSO, say 10 mil for topical use? Now I think this is a great question, because when I normally dilute DMSO for my own personal use, I generally make up a 500 mil bottle to use as and when. It never really occurred to me to mix DMSO in such small quantities, but if you think about it, it would give you the flexibility of being able to use different dilution strengths from one bottle, instead of using the majority of that bottle for just one mix. So after pondering on the question, I thought that the easiest way would be to use a small sterile syringe. You can purchase different sizes of syringe, so this one measures up to 10 mil, whereas this one measures just 1 mil. So you can achieve extremely small yet accurate dilution quantities, which can then be stored in glass dropper bottles, ready for use whenever and wherever you are. The next question asked was, how long does the dilution last for, or does it have a shelf life? Now this is another great question. DMSO has antibacterial, antifungal and antiviral properties, and in my experience, when it's diluted to at least a 50% solution, it has an indefinite shelf life. Now that being said, I am a regular user of DMSO, so relatively speaking, a bottle doesn't tend to last me that long. Pure DMSO does not have a use-by or sell-by date and can last for years. It does sometimes have a retest date to comply with the manufacturer's certificate of analysis, which is generally around 2 to 3 years after manufacture. Now lastly, we're asked if the readily diluted DMSO solution could be put into a spray glass bottle and applied topically. And the answer to this is yes, this is a perfectly acceptable way to use DMSO and is, I think, a great way of having it to hand when you're out and about. Now the guys over at Regency Organics supply a 70-30 DMSO solution ready to use in a 250ml bottle. And the spray bottles they use are made from high density polyethylene or HDPE, and it is suitable for the long term storage of DMSO. Now remember, DMSO is a solvent and can dissolve certain types of plastic, so if you have any doubts, always use glass bottles when swapping containers. As I've just mentioned that DMSO is a solvent that can attack certain types of plastics, I think it might be prudent to also mention that it can attack the varnish on furniture, as well as other synthetic materials such as polyester, nylon, rayon and acrylic. So when using DMSO, you should keep it away from any furniture or clothing and materials that you don't want to ruin or damage. Make sure you replace the top securely on the bottle, wiping off any drips that may have occurred with cotton or cotton wool. Well, we're now approaching the end of this video, and I hope it's been informative and helpful to you, and I hope that you'll check out our other videos. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button below if you want to see any more of our content and future videos and updates. Also, you can find us on Facebook and Instagram. Just search for All About DMSO. This is also the easiest way to contact us if you need any help and advice, if you have any questions or concerns, or need any other general information regarding DMSO. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.